until I come again. I put this second commandment there because until I come again, I want you to dream of me. Fill up your imagination with dreams of me. You see, your imagination is a very important part of the work that needs to take place in your heart. To me, I call the imagination the eye of the soul. To me, the imagination is the room where you meet with God and where you dream of being with God and where you dream of being like God in motive and character. That's what Jesus meant when he said, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy soul and all thy mind. God is saying to us, until you see my face, no idols, dream of me. Faith is the substance of things hoped for. Dream of me. The evidence of things not seen. Dream of me. One day, I gotta tell you, I've been telling people lately that God has shown me that loving God is life's greatest romance. He doesn't want you to make a stone, an idol, and of anything. He says, dream of me. And so when I pray, I see myself as a blind woman waiting on the arrival of her lover. I can't see his face, but I can hear his voice. I can hear his whisperings. I can feel his presence. And like that beautiful song says, Jesus, lover of my soul, I dream of him. And I'm not ashamed to tell you and to announce that I am in love with one whom I cannot see. And it is the purest love affair I've ever known. God says, no idols. You dream of me. Dream of me. Fill your heart with visions of pleasing me. And so I tell you, I don't need an idol. I have filled up my imagination with dreams of the love of my soul. I live for just a glimpse and vision of his smile. How is it that you may ask that I am attracted to one I have never seen? I think it is because one day I heard and read that he first loved me. Not for who I am, but in spite of who I am. And therefore, loving this great invisible God I cannot see has become the first and most important and joyous responsibility of my life. I don't need an idol. Amen. I can sense his presence. Amen. It's almost when God walks into my room that the molecular makeup of the room changes. Something shimmers. I don't need an idol. I've got his presence. A young woman in England many years ago always wore a golden locket, and she would not allow anyone to open it. She would not allow anyone to look into it. And everyone thought that there must be some romance connected with that locket, and that maybe in that locket was the picture, a picture of the one that she loved. The young woman died one day at a very early age, and after her death, the locket was opened. Everyone was wondering whose face they would find within that locket. Oh, but in that locket, all they found was a simple, crumpled piece of paper with these words written upon it: whom, having not seen, I love. I don't need an idol. He whom I have never seen, he fills my heart. Jesus, lover of my soul, let me to thy bosom fly. Her Lord Jesus was the lover she longed for, and that locket reminded her of that. And so as I leave you today, you don't need an idol. As long as you stay in love with this one that you cannot see, one day, I said one day, you shall see him face to face. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands has made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think of God, his Son, not sparing, gave him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the cross my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Acclamation to take me home. What joy shall fill my heart, and I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, Savior God, to thee, thou art, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great